This is Denise, Long Beach, Mississippi, Long Beach Harbor, and today is Monday, Labor Day. And suffice to say, for a holiday, it's a little barren, is it not? Nobody pulling up boats, nobody launching a boat. I saw two couples fishing. Here's the brand new, like $1.5 million Harbor Master house. Guess that was money well spent. Because for the past 5 years, they were in a little portable trailer right here. And that seemed to work, but they had to build a $1.5 million building. What could they have done with that $1.5 million towards cleaning up this mess? I have to ask that. Do we see the boom here? Dirty boom. And there's a light oil sheen on the water tonight. I just think I'll take a moment to explain myself. I know I've been doing this for 4 months now. Oh, we have a boat coming in. A boat. But yeah, I've been doing this now for 4 months. And I just wanted to say, you know, that I'm doing this for a reason. I'm not doing this for its entertainment value or its shock value or anything of that nature. I don't have any other motive other than to just let people see and observe for themselves what is happening here. For real, because what the news media is now no longer even finding newsworthy. And what they've lied about in the past, and completely misled everyone about, is the true facts are that we are dealing with a horrendous problem here. We have tar balls, we have oil sheen, we have fish kills, we have Corexit, we have all of this stuff is still very much here. They're still spraying at night. And if they're not spraying from planes, they're spraying it from boats. The skimmer boats go out at night with tanks and tanks and tanks, drums of guess what on it. They're not going out and fertilizing the seagrass. And, you know, people just have to know that we're being killed. We're being poisoned. And it continues. And they're trying to sweep it under the rug. They're trying to shut us up. We're starting to get threats. Those of us who still continue to forge on and try to show people what's going on. You know, I don't know how serious a threats anybody else has gotten. I've not been seriously threatened, but I've just been, you know, attacked basically verbally and told that I'm a drama queen and that kind of thing. So, you know, I mean, no big deal. But others I know of that have been more vocal than I have gotten more serious attacks on their selves, you know. So anyway, once again, I just want to tell everybody that we need help. We need some answers. We need scientists who are impartial to come down here and get us some answers, do some testing. You know, we've tried to do our own testing and we've been told that we've collected it wrong, it's not in the right kind of container, we didn't freeze it at the proper time, etc. We're not chemists, we're not scientists, we're just very passionate and compassionate at the same time, and we're concerned about ourselves, and we're concerned about our families, and we're concerned about our friends and neighbors, and we're concerned about our Gulf and our seafood and our, you know, our way of life that is all but just dying before our eyes and continues to be. This isn't going to go away without help, and if it's not too late, we need help. Contact us, and if there's anything you can offer that might help us to make some headway against the government and the news media and big corporations that are killing us. They're killing us.